giro ombere inshuti yukuri ombaye hafi muri byose uranyitangira sinari kushobora kugera kuri ibi byose iyo ntakugira
Music is everyone's identity, regardless of the age, the gender, profession, lifestyle, or any other attributes. Therefore, the need of exploring the positive and negative impact of music lyrics on interpersonal communication and the society as a whole is a vital study. This study will allow songwriters to know which direction they should take in order for their terms and writing to be more acceptable and constructive in the society. These songwriters and artists are the role models of many people, especially the youth, who are still trying to get their direction and lifestyle that they do not have. They don't have the identity, so they need this identity and they get it from you artists. So we are looking at the impact of the song lyrics. How do terms that appear in songs affect the society, and how do people incorporate these terms in their everyday language, which in the end affects language and also communication? Let's take a simple example. Going to America and Europe, where this industry has grown significantly, we have seen that many of the youth in America are trying to talk and behave in a way that they listen to songs and incorporate their terms in their everyday communication as they talk. So we need also to see whether this is the kind of route we want to take in our language. In reality, Rwanda, we do not have this much influence, but when we take a range of 2012 and 2015, we see that our artists have grown more creative and more writing has come to the market. The competition is very high, and so we need to tackle this issue, though not many people have tried to get fully these terms from their language. So like when you go to Nyamirambo, you get people talking and you wonder, what does this mean? And as we know, the language grows and dies. So do we want these terms in Kinyarwanda, or how do these songs and song lyrics affect people in Rwanda? This is the objective of my study.
On American society, let's take a look on the artists in America. How are they now talking? How their message are affecting the public? Look, we have Rihanna. We have Jay-Z, we have Stromae in Europe, and we have others all around the world, and their messages are affecting the interpersonal communication. And so, how should PR practitioners also incorporate these words in their everyday relation with the public?
You tell me it gets better. It gets better in time. You say I pull myself together, pull it together, you'll be fine. Tell me, what the hell do you know? What do you know? Tell me, how the hell could you know? Till it happens to you, you don't know.
Parecerá lleno, van a llevarlo. Nabura gatabinguvana shingurwa.
For us to learn more, I've gone to different experts in the field, and they will tell us how they see this, how is it affecting the public, and how should it work, and for us to have an insight on how public relations practitioners should also be, you know, dealing with the public. Let's talk to Lion Manzi, the presenter, the experienced MC, and the artist himself. And he's a character, a media character. He's very known in Rwanda. Let's talk to Lion Manzi.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Would you introduce yourself to the audience?
No, it's my pleasure. My name is Lion Manzi. I'm a radio and TV personality, a professional MC, a voice actor, an overall artist, but I'm also a songwriter and a singer.
Oh, great.
Yes.
So, as a songwriter, you know, we see people interacting every day.
Yes.
And they pick up some terms from songs.
Yes.
And these terms are affecting communication generally.
Yes.
So, what is your view on this?
My view on this is two ways, twofold.
Yeah.
There is the impact that songwriting and lyrics specifically have on society and the way they communicate and the terms they take from music, from the most popular songs. They usually hear a term and it's a cute one usually, and they will use it on a daily basis in communicating with their friends.
Yeah.
The same way, interpersonal communication affects songwriters and the way they write their songs. You can have a term, for example, that is maybe not mainstream or popular,
yep,
that they will take, put into a song, and all of a sudden it goes wild. Everyone mm-hmm. starts to use it. So it definitely, there is an impact both ways.
I know. So that's where we're going. The creative writers,
yes,
are like making communication or languages grow.
Yes.
But like the way the language is growing, sometimes it looks like it's losing the focus. Like for example, we know languages that are being they are dying, literally they are dying. So like for example in Rwanda,
yes,
we have some terms that we picked from songs. For example, say tayari, that's not in Rwanda.
Yes,
nidanje, it's not in Rwanda. So what do you say about that? The language is growing, but again, it's like dying.
The language, it's a typical thing to happen for young people to come up with new words, new terms, new ways of saying things. But if a language dies, it wouldn't be their fault, or I wouldn't pin it on them necessarily. Every country and every culture has its own responsibilities to, first of all, document their language, put it into writing, trying to understand the structure of the language, and understanding how to best incorporate new terms, if those new terms work well with that language, or if they are popularly used. But one does not necessarily affect the other. It's a matter of having the right policies for those countries and those governments and those particular cultures to maintaining their language. But I think whatever the youth brings to the table is always something interesting to hear, to see. Sometimes makes it even easier and more pleasant. But what you will notice is that the terms you use, even for yourself as you were younger, as you grow older, you tend to shy away from those terms and you go back to the original or the quote-unquote proper way of talking. So it's a normal process.
Oh, so yeah. So then we could say we encourage the creative writers and the songwriters to come up with more terms or pick them from other languages and incorporate them in Kinyarwanda or...
I would neither encourage nor discourage. The one thing about creativity is that it takes you wherever it wants to take you. I don't think there's a concerted effort from songwriters or from creative people to try to come up with these things. I think that the process is more organic. Yep. Sometimes it's something you've picked up because you heard someone say it and you thought it was something nice, or it's something that in the process of your creativity you have this epiphany, let me call it that.
Yep.
and you describe something. You have the talent when you're a creative writer to beautify things or describe them in an original way.
Yep.
So I think it happens organically, and I don't think we should discourage that to happen. It helps society grow.
Yep.
At the same time, we should have on the other side ways of preserving, at the very least, the origin, the structure of the language. But we only stand to gain from new things, wherever they come from. And whatever is not good, then we do away with it.
Okay, cool.
Yes.
Now we are going to talk to the one and only Mr. Mani Martin, the artist who has gone beyond the borders of Rwanda. His music is affecting the public in general in Africa. The music goes on BBC, VOA, and all the medias in Rwanda. So let's talk to Mani Martin, hear from what he says on this topic. How does his music or his fellow's music affecting the Rwandan society, the language? And so, seeing this impact, how do we as public relations practitioners know also deal with our public in our everyday work?
My name is Mani Martin. I'm a Rwandan musician. I do kind of Afro-fusion styles and traditional music. I'm also a student at Mount Kenya University. And that's all.
Yeah, as a famous artist, you've built your name. And you've composed songs, right? So how do you see people turning to pick words from your songs and using them in their everyday communication?
Well, when you talk of music lyrics is impact on our daily communication, you first think of the music power. Music has power to the people, to the society, that you can't even control. Every language in the world has the original language and the slang version of it. I think it happens everywhere. So the task they have is to encourage the weak in Rwanda, but they don't have to fight against those terms. I'm just saying this as an entertainment person.
Coming at a music producer, to see how much the music they produce affect the public and how they are now affecting the public in terms of their everyday communication.
How do you see the songs you produce affecting the public?
Yeah, there are different types of songs, of course, and some that I produce and others that are produced by other producers. What I see is that mainly the songs that are produced in general by different producers or any other one, they affect for sure the culture of people, either the language and other also action that they do in their life.
For sure, that's sure. They change different types of using expressions. The way people are expressing themselves is different because of the words brought from the different songs of the artists.